Digitalization is around us everywhere. We see this in the Internet of Things, where we have machines talking to machines, we have sensors, we have smart cards, we have customer loyalty programs. Wherever people are moving, there is some kind of a track or some kind of an information as to what they're doing. And now, because of the technology, we're able to capture that. And we're able to capture it in a totally different manner with great detail. We have both structured data, for example, your customer loyalty card. They know where you've been shopping, what you shopped for, when you shopped for it, what day you shopped for it, and that might in fact impact the types of offers that you're given. But we also have the unstructured data, which is when you Twitter or tweet to your followers saying, I just found this great piece of venison at the local market, hurry and come and buy it. And of course, as a market or as a business, these are things I want to know. All of this information is out there. It's in databases everywhere. And now, with the HANA technology, we're able to bring it together and bring it together in such a way that businesses can leverage this and look at the information in a meaningful manner. We also have questions now that come up about sustainability. How do we use this information? Where is it being stored physically in many ways? And then, of course, we have ethics. Who owns the information? Is it myself as the consumer, or is it the business which is providing me services, and what do we do with that? So all of these bits are different dimensions of the digitalization of the world. And T-Systems is very unique in that we have security, we have ethics, we talk about sustainability, and we have an offering which is able to, that businesses are able to use. So like 4 years ago, SAP introduce HANA to the marketplace, and this was a revolution because it's a totally different type of database. Unlike the old physical databases where you have heads moving back and forth on a physical disk, you now have something that's called in-memory computing. This made things immensely faster. So of course SAP first introduced this on Business Warehouse, which is the analytics engine that SAP offers to the market. Using this as a basis, BW on HANA or BI on HANA, then we're able to expand the ecosystem and create the applications that require the information that can be stored in a HANA database. In a T-Systems case, it's something called Digifront.
And as the name aligns, there is a solution to digitalize all the data and bring it into the front end to the users. And to do it in a very fast way, we have now three steps to just design the KPI tiles together with the customer, to deploy this solution on the customer environment, and to actuate this. And all these actions should be done on an agile way with the new agile project methodology, so that in one sprint and at the end of this sprint, we will have a productive solution working on the customer's engine and the customer's environment. We just see on the left side the navigation, on the right side the detailed level of the solution. It are very modern components involved in this case, meaning we have the KPI tiles, which are created by our design departments. And on the other hand, we have SAP standard products like Design Studio, which are integrated in these solutions as well. And so the customer had the possibility to gain the data and to make the potential of digital data on a very fast way. That means we just go to the data sources, identify together with the customer the data which is necessary for this solution, for this use case, and then in three steps, and in a very short time, we will just onboarding this solution by the customer.